my son out there, Lee. Good. Then good.
DJ L-Will.
L-Will.
Can I pay my pastor visit? Centennial Compton School District. And video campus, shut the fuck up your premises. Kendrick and Westchester had the baddest bitches. And my nigga L. Wood had the white Toyota. And we got pulled over, had to hide the bottles because they was mixed with Hennessy and soda. Every time we rolled up, we was unsober. And everybody had know that my nigga Yan Yan had the RAP hat, which really was dumb because where we was at was the other side. And more than likely, the other side really didn't like that. Didn't have no burner, so if they would shot us, we never really could shoot back. Could've lost our life over hood rats. We was dumb as fuck, but lucky for us, we was lucky enough that the black car didn't pull up and ask where y'all niggas from. I know some nigga less fortunate was fucking with they enemies. She had a fat ass and a brown Camaro, but it wasn't that fast. It was like a V6, but anyway, she was one of those hoes in high school with the cornrows, sci-fi Jordans, Rolex button. And when I fight everybody, she knows what she was important. But she wasn't, she was just so-and-so cousin. He was a rep, so anytime she got into it, that's who she would get. Now let me get back to the plan. Homie had asked, do you got a man? She said no, he said, oh yeah. Where do you stay? She said, Rosecrans and what? She said, don't matter, just know I fuck. He said, what? You're a little freaky bitch, huh? She said, yeah, daddy, I can get you sprung. I can work that pussy and the tongue. If you come over, I can make you come. If you come over, make sure that you bring drink, because I'd like to get drunk. And that he did. That Friday, he was where she lived. Noticed that he was out of bounds, but didn't give up, cause he wanted to fuck that bitch right now. Walk in the house, rubber on, panties down, oldies playing in the background. Let's get it on. Marvin Gaye had bumped to the mall. Meantime to go pick his pants up off the floor, kiss that bitch in the mouth, then walk to the door. When he walked out, he seen a 4-4. No. Didn't know that was that pussy he was dealing with. And that's how you get your ass killed, bitch. That's how you get your ass killed, bitch. That's how you get your ass killed, bitch. Get your ass killed, bitch. How? Fucking with them hoes. Them hoes, them hoes, them hoes. Them hoe hoes, them scandalous hoes. Them hoe hoes that have you, dead, dead, dead. Look, I guess we all can learn from mistakes. But your first mistake might be your death date. And death doesn't wait on no one. A million ways to die, and you can make it a million and one if you're not aware of the rules. Or maybe trying to fill someone else's shoes. Like a square trying to be a gangster. Kinda real mommy of this one dude. He was 13, he was 22 when he went the first get put on the hood. He wasn't born in it. Boys in the Hood, the movie, made him think it was all good. But usually this type of person wanna prove his self on purpose. Tell everybody he put work in, but really he's worthless. His mama had money, his daddy had money, so he had money. The OGs that gave him a pistol said it was gonna be just another crash dummy. And the funny thing about it, he thought he was about it. Like P. Miller, but he wasn't no killer, just a monkey hanging around a bunch of gorillas. Everybody wanna be tough guy, so he did approach this guy like, where are you from? Where his gun? But then shoot it. Rule number one, never pull out if you don't use it. Even though the dude then banged up every next day, he seen him around the way, blew his brains out while homeboy was cruising. Not knowing the scariest nigga split your shit. And that's how we got his ass killed, bitch. That's how we got his ass killed, bitch. That's how we got his ass killed, bitch. Fuck around and get your ass killed, bitch. How? Not knowing the G-codes. The codes, the codes, the G-codes. The codes, the codes, the G-codes. If you don't know, then you're already dead. Dead, dead. Feel me?